Yes. So now I'm coming to the book. I'm going to read, and after that, again, I'll start explaining. Agriculture. India is an agriculturally important country, as I told you earlier. Two-thirds of its population is engaged in agricultural activities. Out of three parts, two parts are into agriculture, two-thirds. Agriculture is a primary activity which produces most of the food that we consume. Beside food grains, it also produces raw materials for various industries. Now, can you name some industries based on agricultural raw material? Moreover, some agricultural products like tea, coffee, spices, etc. are also exported. I told you about the exporter. Industries which are based on agricultural raw materials. What is agricultural raw material? From the agriculture, whatever crop is coming out, that is the raw material they are using to produce something more fine. But tea. You just can't go to a tea garden, pick up a tea leaf and drink tea. Tea will not be made. Sugar, you just can't take a sugar cane and cut a piece of sugar cane and put it into your tea, it becomes sweet. Cotton, you just can't go take cotton and wear it and stitch it together and you wear it. Sugar industry, what is the raw material? Sugarcane. Cotton industry is cotton. Jute, textile industry. Vegetable oil industry. Coffee industry. Floriculture based industry. Fruits and vegetable based industry. The juice. Maza mango, Alfonso mangoes. Katrina Kaif says that, oh, it's Alfonso. True taste of Alfonso. Then you have Minute Maid, orange juice. It says the orange pulp inside the juice. You get orange pulps. You can chew that orange pulp, you get that chewy effect. So this is industry. You just can't buy an orange and you want to have it as a juice. You have to go and make it at home. So that's when you are making that juice at home, also fresh fruits. That's also a part of the raw material which you are making into a glass of juice. But that is for your own favor. But when it is going into a massive output in the domestic or in the commercial market, it has to go through an industry. The raw material is needed heavily. Okay, so these are the ones. Next, we come to types of farming. Agriculture is an age-old economic activity in our country. Over these years, cultivation methods have changed significantly, depending upon the characteristics of physical environment, technological know-how and socio-cultural practices. I'll read that again for you. See, agriculture is an age-old economic activity in our country. As I told you, it goes back down to the Indus Valley civilization. Over the years, cultivation methods have changed significantly depending upon the characteristics of the physical environment, the geographical factors. Technological know-how. Technological know-how means the techniques of growing that. First, they were just gathering seeds, hunters and gatherers, they were throwing a seed, a wild seed went up and it came back as a plant. Oh, this is a plant. Okay, so they started eating. But they did not have the technological effect know-how from subsistence to commercial time. And the socio-cultural practices, the social environment, the cultural practices of what was happening, it was gradually coming into form. Now, farming also varies from subsistence to commercial. What is subsistence? Subsistence is something which you are doing for yourself. Okay. Subsistence is doing something for yourself and to commercial type. You have a small part of land, you only till on that, you only do that, and only you depend upon the climate. Water you don't have, you depend, you do that farming according to the seasons. That is subsistence. And you only procure for yourself and your family. Now, at present in different parts of India, the following farming systems are practiced. What are they? Primitive subsistence farming. This is only practiced in few pockets of India, or rather few parts of India. It is practiced on small patches of land with the help of primitive tools. With the tools which you have, local normal tools. This farming also depends upon the monsoons and natural fertility of the soil. It is also called slash and burn agriculture. These are practiced like primitive tools like hoe, dao, digging sticks, and the families involved into it, community labor you take. Like someone else is there, he is not able to eat food, he is also in that same village or in that same land area. He comes and says, okay, I am going to do it for you, how much will you give me? And it's this type of farming depends only on monsoons. And suitably for other environment conditions to the crop grown. That is primitive farming. Okay, it is the oldest form of agriculture and still it is there in some areas of the world. It is a self-sufficient basis. Those who farm on that primitive farming or do the farming, they only gather, they only grow food for themselves and their families. And some surplus may be sold for cash or for in a barter system. I have still seen some people in the remote hillside areas, they come with their things, they don't want to go in for cash. They bring in things and they take back things. The barter system still goes on. Or some people sell it for cash. Right? This is primitive farming. But if I give it into a explanation of that slash and burn agriculture, a patch of land is cleared, slashing the vegetation, and then slashed plants are burnt. The ash is obtained and mixed with soil and crops are grown again. One production is done. The farming is done on that agricultural land, the farming is done, it's harvested, and whatever the leftover of that harvest is there, it is burnt. And the ash is again mixed with the soil and crops are grown. Okay. Now it has different characteristics. Okay, as I said, slash and burn depends on monsoon and natural fertility of the soil. Environmental suitability has to be there. Primitive tools like hoe, dao, digging sticks are used. Okay, so back to your book. This type of farming is practiced in few pockets of India. Primitive subsistence agriculture is practiced on small patches of land with the help of primitive tools like hoe, dao, and digging sticks and family community labor. That's what I explained just now. I didn't touch your book also. This type of farming depends upon monsoon, natural fertility of the soil, and suitability of other environmental conditions for the, or to the crop grown. It is a slash and burn agriculture. Farmers clear a patch of land and produce cereals and other food crops to sustain their family. When the soil fertility decreases, the farmers shift and clear another fresh patch of land for cultivation. This type of shifting allows nature to replenish the fertility of the soil through natural processes. Land productivity in this type of agriculture is low as the farmer does not use fertilizers or the modern inputs. It is known by different names in different parts of the country. It is called jhuming in northeast states like Assam, Meghalaya, Mizoram and Nagaland, Pamlo in Manipur, Dipa in Bastar district of Chhattisgarh and in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Jhuming, the slash and burn agriculture, is known as milpa in Mexico and Central America, conuco in Venezuela, milpa in Mexico and Central America, conuco in Venezuela, roca in Brazil, masole in Central Africa, ladang in Indonesia, re in Vietnam. But in India, this primitive form of cultivation is called bewar or dahiya. In Madhya Pradesh, Podu or Penda in Andhra Pradesh, Pamadabi or Koman in or Bringa in Orissa, Kumari in Western Ghats, Valre or Valtre in southeastern regions, Rajasthan, Khil in Himalaya belt, Kuruwa in Jharkhand, and Jhuming in the northeastern region. So we are clear about that. Rinja lived with her family in a small village in the outskirts of Dipu in Assam. She enjoys watching her family members clearing, slashing and burning a patch of land for cultivation. She often helps them in irrigating the fields with water running through a bamboo canal from the nearby spring. She loves the surroundings and wants to stay here as long as she can. But this little girl has no idea about the declining fertility of the soil and her family searches for a fresh patch of land in the next season. So that is slash and burn. So can you name the type of farming Rinja's family is engaged in? So that's your job. Can you enlist some crops which are grown in such farming? Okay. What are the crops grown in slash and burn farming? Decide. That you have to know. I'll come back in the next video.